And joining us now is Bill Bratton. Chief Bratton, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Are you surprised that the lawlessness got so out of hand in London?
No, actually, it was building up and then just finally exploded, and took them several nights to get it under control, but finally they were able to do that.
We're talking about gangs for the most part. Is the gang culture in England significantly different than the gang culture here in the States?
It is, actually. It's a relatively new phenomenon versus here in the States. We've had major gangs in L.A., Chicago for 80 years. In England, it's really the last 20, 30 years where you've had the gang activity that you saw reflected in those disturbances last week.
When you look at the way the police handled this initially, the way the government handled it initially, from your standpoint, could they have done things a lot differently?
Well, I think that's the debate that's now going to occur over there, that most of the politicians are on vacation out of the country. They have bad luck. The country's bad luck, because there was really no face for the public to respond to. Giuliani after 9/11, that here in the United States, police and mayors tend to get out very quickly in front of it. And I think that was missing in Britain for several days, and they began to come back and begin to reassure the public. And the police also really then began to flood the streets with thousands of officers, and that turned the tide.
What crime-fighting techniques that you use so successfully here do you think should be implemented right now in England?
Well, I'm being asked to serve as an unpaid advisor to the government on the issue very specifically of gangs and gang violence. My most recent assignment in the United States was Los Angeles, where we reduced gang violence, homicides by almost 60%, overall gang violence by 50%. You can't control it, you can't reduce it. And the Brits are looking to see if there's things to be learned from the American experience. I think there are. A lot of it is transferable. So I'll enjoy going over and meeting with them, and hopefully that be able to help.
As an unpaid consultant, what do you think your biggest challenge is going to be in solving this problem?
The idea is that there is so much dispute about how do you deal with it. Good news is Los Angeles has been a success story, so you can deal with those that want the hard line and those that want to deal with the soft line. In Los Angeles, we blended both. It has to be comprehensive. You can't arrest your way out of the problem, but arrest a key portion of it. At the same time, you need to have interventionists, you need to have community outreach, you have to grow your department to look more like the community. That's something the Brits are very engaged in, and trying to make the Metropolitan Police, which is about 10% minority in a city that's almost a minority, majority city, they're trying to change that.
It's interesting, there are rumors that you could be asked to be the head of Scotland Yard, something that would be unusual for an American. What do you think about that? Is it a job you're interested in?
I would love the opportunity to have considered applying, but about 2 weeks ago, the Home Secretary restricted it to British citizens, so somewhat of a moot question, but it was fun to entertain for a while.
How long do you expect your assignment to last in London?
Oh, I think it will be short-term. I think several trips over there, they're putting together a number of committees and commissions to look at what happened. So one of the things we do in the private sector is offer our services, and whatever they're looking for, I'm happy to provide.
Okay. Chief Bill Bratton, as always, we appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.